I want to start with the book of Acts because this is the text that will be governing us for this day. The Bible says in Acts chapter 19, and it came to pass that while Apollos was at Corinth, Paul, having passed through the upper course, came to Ephesus, and finding certain disciples, he said unto them, Have you received the Holy Ghost since you believed? And they said unto him, We have not so much as heard whether there be any Holy Ghost. And he said unto them, Unto what then were you baptized? And they said, Unto John's baptism. Then said Paul, John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance, saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come after him, that is, on Jesus Christ. When they had this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul had laid his hands upon them, the Holy Ghost came on them, and they spake with tongues and prophesied. I said that the Holy Spirit dwelling in humanity comes in levels. And I said there are different levels that every Christian must come to a place and says, I have experienced the Holy Spirit. That all of us are not in the same level, but it is our desire, and it is the desire of the Lord, that all of us attain the highest level of His presence in our lives. Because there is still so much in God that if we press on and we press on, we are able to go deeper and deeper and to receive more and more. The river cannot be finished. We can go deeper into this river of the Spirit. We can go deeper into this ocean of the Spirit until we come to a place that our feet cannot stand by ourselves. Somebody say amen with me. There is higher possibility, more than that which we have already received, and we can receive more and more. And every day, God wants to pour more and more and more, because the Holy Spirit is flowing eternally to them that are ready and are open to receive Him. And every day is my prayer that we'll keep on receiving Him into the next level. Somebody clap to the King of Kings and give Him praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, the first level is receiving the Holy Spirit. The first level is to receive the Holy Spirit. And that's why I've started with that scripture when Paul asked them, Have you received the Holy Spirit? That is the first level of the indwelling of the Holy Spirit, is to receive the Holy Spirit. I said yesterday, there is the coming of the Holy Spirit upon a place. But the first level that a person need to have is to receive the Holy Spirit. Not just going into a meeting and saying that the meeting was good and the Holy Spirit was present. Or saying, I saw many people who are healed and the power of God was real there. That is not our level. Our level is us, ourselves, that we start by receiving the Holy Spirit. And that's why the Apostle Paul asked them, Have you received the Holy Spirit? Have you received the Holy Spirit? That is the level that every Christian here must attain today, or if they have not yet attained. It is the first level to receive the Holy Spirit. I want to read this Bible from the book of Romans chapter 8 concerning this first level, verse 14. Romans 8 verse 14. Romans 8 verse 14, if we can get it quickly on the screen, I think I will appreciate. Romans chapter 8 verse 14. 15, 16, 17. I read, the Bible says, For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. For you have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together. Somebody say amen. This is the first level of encounter with the Holy Spirit. And in this level is when somebody has accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Everybody that open themselves and accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, they receive the first dose of the Holy Spirit. They receive the first level of the Holy Spirit. Somebody say amen. If today you are in the midst of us, and then you stand and you say, I have accepted him to be my Lord and Savior, I want to receive him, immediately you receive the first dose of the Holy Spirit. You receive the first level of the Holy Spirit. In this level, your inner being begins to acknowledge Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. In this level, your inner being begins to recognize Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. This is the level where your eyes are open, your inner eyes are open, and you realize that you are no longer a slave of sin, but you have been saved by our Lord Jesus Christ. You have been redeemed, you have been purchased, you have been bought again. This is the level that you come into a place and you begin to realize and to know that I am a born again Christian. This is the level that when you go out of this place and you go to your home, you go to the people, you begin to tell them, do you know that today I am saved? Somebody say amen with me. That's why I call it the first level of encounter with the Holy Spirit. It is the first dose that tells you that now you are no longer a slave. You are no longer a stranger in the house of God, but you are a child of God. That thing that tells you that from today, I am a child of God. That's why the Bible says that you have not received the spirit of bondage to fear, but you have received the spirit of liberty, which is called the Holy Spirit. This is the first level of the infilling or the encounter or the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. Somebody clap to the King of Kings and give him praise today. The first level. That's why I began by saying, the moment you just open your heart, even before you rise up and confess him, the moment you see somebody on the chair there, as you keep on preaching and they are convicted, they are now making decision to receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. The moment you come to that level, the Holy Spirit immediately invades your inner being. When Jesus was a fiwe, and he takes over that inner being, now from that time is the Holy Spirit that propels you to move in the front and to say, today I am receiving Jesus Christ as my Lord and my Savior. And from today, I am no longer a slave of fear, but I am a child of God because I have received the spirit of adoption. Somebody say amen. The spirit that tells me I am a child of God. That's what the Bible says. The spirit causes them to cry, Abba, Father. It gives you a belonging in the presence of God. It gives you a belonging in the household of God. This is the level that now you get the identity into the community of brethren. You get the identity into the community of brethren. Actually, this is the level that the Bible says, in the image of God, after the likeness of God, that you have received in your life. Somebody clap to the King of Kings and give him praise. That is the level. You come to the book of Genesis chapter 1, and where God says, and let us create man in our own image after our own likeness. And therefore he created them. And when he created them, he blessed them and he say, I give you dominion. I give you dominion over all the earth, that you may multiply, you may be fruitful, that you may possess. That is the place you immediately enter into when you receive the Holy Spirit. The dominion is restored back to you. The blessing of the Lord is restored back to you. The fruitfulness from the Lord is restored back to you. The multiplication of the Lord is restored back to you. The ability to subdue is restored back to you. May you receive the Holy Spirit by clapping your hands and celebrating him, our King of Kings, today in the mighty name of Jesus. The first level of the Holy Spirit in our lives is by receiving him. And when you meet somebody that has entered into this level today, they will tell you, I am feeling like a small child. I am feeling like I am born again. I am feeling like I have become new. You will always see something fresh happening in their lives because you have received back that image of God, the likeness after who? After God. Somebody say amen. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. This is the level. That is the level. That's why when Jesus encounters the teacher of the law in the Bible, he tells him, unless you are born of the water and of the Spirit, you cannot see the kingdom of who? Of God. You cannot become a child of God unless you are born of the water and the Spirit. In other terms, he says, unless you are born again. The first level of the Holy Spirit is this level whereby a Christian says, I am now a born again Christian. Somebody say amen. See, all of us can say we have that level today. I am saying this so that you can have a testimony and an assurance that you have already received the Holy Spirit in Jesus' mighty name. Somebody clap to the King of Kings. That's why the Bible says, and in this level, the Spirit bears witness with us. The Spirit bears witness with us that we are the sons of God. We are heirs of God and co-heirs together with Christ. That is what we receive at that particular time. The Spirit begin to bear witness. That's why you will hear us so boldly telling you, I am saved. Another one, I am saved. Sometimes even you are living in a challenging situation, maybe sinful life, but somebody asks you and you tell that person, I am saved, even though I backslided. Sometimes you meet somebody that even does not go to church and you tell them, are you saved? And they tell you, I am saved, even though I am not going to where? To church. Because the Spirit bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. Somebody say amen. That is the first level that every Christian must have. I've encountered many people and they tell you, you tell them, are you filled with the Holy Spirit? They tell you no. You tell them, are you saved? They tell you, I was saved many years ago. Therefore, I am a child of who? Of God. You have already received a measure of the Holy Spirit that assures you you are placed in the house and in the presence of God in Jesus' mighty name. You have already received a seal of the Holy Spirit that marks you as a child of God. From this particular time, you no longer belong to the devil. You belong to God. You have the Spirit of God. And from this particular time, anywhere that the devil still has access in your life, he is called a liar. He is called an intruder. He is called a stranger. He is called a robber. He is called a thief. He is called a destroyer. Because you no longer belong to him, you belong to the kingdom of heaven, even in the mighty name of Jesus. This is the place where the Bible says in the book of Colossians that we have been delivered from the dominion of darkness, and now we have been translated into the kingdom of light, the kingdom of his son, the kingdom of our Lord Jesus Christ. That we no longer belong to the citizenship of the devil, but we belong to the citizenship of God. Therefore, we have power to reject and to refuse him and his advances over our lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray that somebody today, may you receive the Holy Spirit in Jesus' mighty name. Clap to the King of Kings and give him praise. This is the first level of the Holy Spirit. And it is for every Christian. It's for every Christian. Sometimes we have interesting encounters in church. We have stayed with somebody for so many years in church, and then maybe you hear somebody telling you, even though this one comes to church, but they are not yet saved. They are not yet saved. I normally like to dispute. I tell them that I've been seeing this one coming to church every day, but every time I go and speak to that person and I ask that person, are you saved? That person will tell you, I'm not saved, but I've been coming to church. The person that sees this person is because he has seen that this one has not yet received the Holy Spirit, even though he follows Jesus. You know, you can follow Jesus without receiving the Holy Spirit. You can become, that's why in Kenya we are called a Christian nation. It is, most of us are nominal Christians, Christians by name, following Jesus, but have not yet received the Spirit of Jesus. That's why we are not doing the things of Jesus, even though we are in the house of our Lord. May we receive the Holy Spirit today to confirm us in the house of the Lord in Jesus' mighty name. Somebody clap to the King of Kings and give him praise. This is the level when, even when you sin, you get condemned. You feel like you are accused. The level whereby your conscience is awakened again and you have a feeling that I belong to God and that which I have done does not belong to God. Your conscience is pricked. Your conscience is disturbed when you say something that is wrong, when you go to a place that is wrong, when you do something that is wrong. Your conscience is pricked. You are disturbed in your conscience. And you will see somebody coming back to church and telling you, I want to repent. I have sinned against my God. Because you have received the Holy Spirit and is alive inside of you. Keep on telling you who you are and who you are supposed to be. And that you have joined a wrong company of the demons. Return to the house of your Father, even in Jesus' mighty name. Clap to the King of Kings and give him praise in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, when people have come to this place, that is the time you hear people crying when they have done something wrong. Have you ever seen drunkards crying and they are telling you, you know, I am saved, but I have fallen in sin? It is the Holy Spirit in them that is crying, telling them, what have you done to us? Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Have you ever done something and then you keep on, your conscience is being disturbed wherever you are going? It is disturbed wherever you are going because the Holy Spirit is telling you, what have you done to us? This is not who we are supposed to be. We are sons and daughters of God. We are children of God. We are heirs of God, co-heirs together with Christ. Somebody say amen. This is the first level. And many, many Christians remain in this level. Yet, this is the introductory level. I said, it's like the first dose of the Holy Spirit. You have to continue until you complete everything for it to be effective in your life. Somebody say amen with me. Many Christians have remained in this level for a long time. That's why we have church. You know, in this level, you don't experience that power of God that the Bible says you will receive power when the Holy Spirit come upon you. You don't receive that power. You only receive the power to be called a son of God. You receive that power. But that power that you're able to exercise a lot of authority over the creation, you still need to go deeper and deeper and deeper, even in Jesus' mighty name. Somebody say amen. You have just crossed the River Jordan and you have entered the promised land. But you have not begun to occupy the places in the promised land. You have just entered there. You have just crossed the River Jordan. You have just been baptized in the Spirit and now you have been given a new name, a name that you belong to God. You are a child of God. You are a son of God. And you can move further and demand for more and more, even in Jesus' mighty name. Somebody clap to the King of Kings and give him praise. In this level, we are made to know God more. That's why I said we read the Bible and read the Bible. We are made to know God more. In this level, we are made to know God more. We are made to know his power. We are made to know that he can heal us. We are made to know that he can deliver us. We are made to know that he can bless us. We are made to know that he is a holy God. We are made to know God can intervene in the situations of our lives. This is the first level. We increase our knowledge of God. We are not like the people of the world. They know God, but they don't know God more. When we come into this level, we begin to know God more. The Holy Spirit begins to teach us. That's why the Bible says that you do not need any man to teach you anything, but the anointing that you have received shall teach you everything in Jesus' mighty name. Hey, somebody say amen. In this level, we are made to love God more. We are made to love God more. Our passion for God increases. We desire to love him. We cannot go very far away from him. We keep on coming back to church. We keep on coming back to the household of God. We keep on coming back to repent. We keep on coming back to confess. The Christian of this level, they are good in confessing their sins. They will always tell you, let me just tell you the truth. Staki kukosea Mungu wangu, let me just tell you the truth. Staki kukua adui na Mungu wangu, let me just tell you the truth. Because your love for God increases. May you receive the Holy Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And that's why many have been kept in the house of the Lord because of that first love. That's why the Bible says in the book of Revelation, return to the first love. It makes you hot for God. You just love Him. You don't have so many things, but you just love Him. Sometimes even you don't imagine that you can receive so much from Him, but you just love Him. This is where religious movements have remained. They have said, as long as you have received Him, that is enough. We can stay there. You have not run so far away from the fire. You have just crossed the river Jordan. Somebody say amen. Hey, a better amen here. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. In this particular level, we can pray. We can pray. That's why the Bible says that the Holy Spirit cry inside of us, Abba, Father. That is a cry of prayer, calling your Father. This is the level like when a child suddenly discovers that this is my father, this is my mother. I can ask them anything. I can run to them. I can cry to them. Somebody say amen. They know that not every father is my father. Therefore, I cannot keep on running to every man because he's a man. There is a special man that I call him my father. I cannot keep on running to all women, calling them mother. There is a special woman that is called my mother. Somebody say amen. Now you begin to understand that all other gods are the works of men, but you alone are Jehovah, the Most High God. That you dissuade other idols and you begin to say, I am a believer of God. You become a monolithic person, a person who worship only one God. Somebody clap to the King of Kings and give Him praise, even in the mighty name of Jesus. This is that level that you don't say, oh, every God is my God. You know, many religions say there are religions that they have thousands and thousands of gods. Thousands and thousands. They have known God a little bit, but they have not yet discovered that they only have one God. They have known so many gods, but they have not discovered that they only have one God. Because they have not received this measure of the Spirit that calls God Abba, Father. Personalizing our God, even in Jesus' mighty name. Their religion that even our God is their God. Our Jesus is their God. And even the pastor, if you pray for them and they are healed, they put your picture there and you become their God. Because they have not received the Spirit that tells them, Abba, Father. Somebody say amen. This is a level different. That's why you see somebody was a traditionalist. He used to call the sun his God, moon his goddess. He used to call the mountain God. He called rivers God. But when he comes to this place, he say, I have God. Who is in heaven? That's why we say, I am saved. I am not as the way I used to be. Because the Spirit in you cries out, Abba, Father. Hallelujah, somebody. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hey, you know Him. You differentiate Him from other God. You get a belonging in His presence. As I said, when a child is small, you can keep on tossing. Actually, children know their mother faster than their father because the mother feeds them. But the father, the one who will be very present, will be the father. The one who will always be very present will be the father. Even if you are the father and you are not present, the child will not call you the father. The child will call another person the father, the one that is present. Why? Because of the relationship. He has received the spirit of that man. If you allow other men around your children more than you, they receive the spirit of that man. And then that man becomes a father. I pray that may we receive the spirit of God that will cause us to call Him Abba, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. This is that level that you say, this one is a man, this one is a man, this is my uncle, this is my brother, this is so and so, but this one is my father. You own God. You make Him to belong to you. That's why somebody will say, my God, my God. He becomes your own God. You come from our, he becomes my. You know, when the child is a baby, he never says our father. Even if there are 10 in that family, the small child is the owner of the father. He says, my father, achilia baba yangu, nani baba yenu wote. You own him, you possess him. This is the level when God becomes your God, personal God. You own him, you possess him in Jesus' mighty name. Somebody clap to the King of Kings. Let us give him praise. Let us praise him as we are winding up. This is the level we can pray, I've said. We receive a measure of faith. A measure of faith. That is the ability to believe God. We don't believe him in everything, but we believe him according to our small world of operation. Bwanesu asifiwe. We believe him according to a small word of our operation. We don't believe him in so many things, but we receive a measure of faith in this particular level. That's why somebody goes and say, I am saved. Pastor, pray for me. I want to have peace. We get a measure of faith. May God increase your measure of faith today in Jesus' mighty name. Clap to him in Jesus' mighty name. In this level, we begin to experience the work of transformation inside of us. The Holy Spirit begins to work transformation inside of us. We get something that is called regeneration. The old man begins to fade away and the new nature begins to take over. You know, before we receive him, we normally have something that is called the old nature according to the manner of sin. He keeps on living in us. That's why when somebody is not saved, he can insult you, he can beat you up, he can do anything to you. But the moment they get saved, something in them begins to reduce from evil. And the good thing begins to do what? To increase. You get something that is called regeneration. The Spirit of God begins to take over your being. And the spirit of the enemy begins to fade away from you. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Transformation. You will see the way they are speaking. You will see the way they are thinking. You will see the way they are sleeping. They will begin to not to like sin so much, even though they may not be so strongly delivered from sin. But it will not be their number one thing. Somebody say amen with me. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. A regeneration. Something new is happening in you. A new spirit is created. This is where David says, create in me a new heart, a clean heart. Renew a right spirit within me. Somebody say amen. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ. That is the first level of the encounter with the Holy Spirit. He begins to create fruits in us. He begins to create fruits in us. Things that other people can see. We begin to manage things like anger. Patience begin to come. Love begin to come. Understanding begin to come. Good things of the Lord begins to happen around us. People can associate with us and see a good thing inside of us. Even in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As I'm winding up, in this particular level, he only works in us, not outside of us. He works in us. Is your level utasema wacha wende uombe watu? Isi level utasema wacha wende uhubirie watu? Na hapo ndio makosa. Watu wanaokoka na wanakimbia kuhubiria watu. Hapo ni anatufanya kazi ndani yetu ya kututengeneza sisi. Anatubomoa ili atujenge. Anatuondoa ili atupande, atuweke. Anatungoa ili atupande. Katika jina safi la Yesu Kristo, tuseme amen. Unajua kuna watu wanakuanga kimbele mbele sana. Wanaokoka leo na wanakuwa pastor leo. Wanataka kuhubiria watu leo. Wanataka kuombea wagonjwa leo. Lakini ndani bado. Ndani bado. Ni kama nyumba yenye imeisha huku nje. Lakini ndani mamawe imejaa, kila kitu mbaya iko huko ndani. Na hiyo nyumba iko nje inataka watu watamani from outside. In this level you allow God to work in you. And most Christians have not left that level. Most Christians have not that level. Hawa Kristo wenye kuwaguza kidogo wanalia, wanapiga nduru, wanakutukana, wana walk away, wanafanya all those things, they are still in that level. Hata kama wameka kwa salvation 78 years. Somebody clap to the King of Kings and give him praise. Uko tu wewe bado hapa ni mzima. Unatengenezwa, unachimbwa. You are being drilled. You are living for nothing. You are just living for yourself. Christ is fighting to have a space inside of you. Most Christians remain there. They never left that particular place. Because kuna tamaa ya kufanyia Mungu kazi. Kuna tamaa. And that's why unaona Yesu aliambia hawa, don't leave Jerusalem. Tarry until you receive power. After the Holy Spirit comes upon you. You are filled until you overflow. That is the time you begin to work for God. Don't try to work for God before you are filled until you overflow. Utatumia resources zako. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hii ni kama ule mtu mwenye tu amepata kazi ya kwanza na anataka kusomesha ndugu zake, dada yake, kujengea mama yake nyumba, kufanya utafilisika. Utafilisika. You don't have enough to give out in this level. You only have enough for yourself. Hey, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Tunaelewana watu wa Mungu. Mbona wale watu umepata kazi, hata mshahara ya kwanza ujepata, umechukua madeni, umepeleka ndugu zako shule, dada yako shule, umetaka kujenga nyumba, by the time unapata mshahara ya kwanza umefutwa kazi kwa sababu ya madeni mingi. You don't have enough to support others. This level is your level with God. If you get a good pastor and you run to serve in this level, he will tell you, please sit down until you grow. Situpigie Bwana Yesu makofi. Most of us have remained there. Most of us are still in this level. Why? Because we disallowed the process. We disallowed the process. If we allow the process, we are drilled in this level until we begin to bear fruit. The Bible says, fruit that will last. We shall bear fruit, the fruit that will last. I've seen people opening churches in this level. They open churches with their flesh. And the church prosper. After 3 months, that church has become a den of robbers. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Funny things are happening there. Because there's nothing. You don't have anything. You just have something for you, not for others. And you're trying to do it for others. I've seen people after this level, they have run around praying for everybody, prophesying to everybody. After some time, they have fallen into sin. Why? You don't have enough for others. You only have for you. To build you, to work in you. This is the time that you allow the Holy Spirit to work in you. In Jesus' mighty name. Somebody say amen. Hey, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Naona hapa mjependa, kumbe ningechukua sadaka kwanza. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. This is the level of most of us. Unaona mtoto mdogo mwenye ameanza kujua baba yake. Ukimpea toy akupei tena. Ukimpea toy apei mtu mwingine tena. Ukimpea mkate, umwambie gawio wengine, anakuambia ni yangu. That is the level where we are. We possess him. Ni Mungu wetu. Personal God. And you jealously guard that level until you grow to the next level. In Jesus' mighty name. Let us stand in his presence. Tumeelewana watu wa Mungu? Watu wengi wako wapo. Makasiriko kanisani. Makasiriko ya kutosha. Mtu anataka kukulea hands, lakini ile makasiriko anabeba. Ukimuguza tu hivi kidogo, ana backslide. Hapa ndio wale wa Kristo nasikianga Mungu wajejibu maombi yao, wana backslide. Ati nimekunywa leo pombe kwa sababu mtoto yangu amekuwa mgonjwa. You try to relate pombe na mtoto mgonjwa, they don't agree. In fact, pombe itafanya mtoto akuwa mgonjwa zaidi. Situfunge macho, tuinulie Mungu mkono na tuombe. Kidogo tu kwa haraka, nena na Mungu. Jana nilisema tusome Bible. Naomba tuendelee kusoma Biblia. Kama uliweza 5, ongeza nyingine 5. Kama uliweza 2, ongeza nyingine 2. Kama uliweza 1, ongeza nyingine 1. Kama ukuweza chochote, jaribu moja leo. Speak to the Lord for a minute. In the mighty name of Jesus. Tell the Lord, I want to go deeper than this level. Because most of us are still in this level. You can't do anything. You can't. Tell the Lord, I want to go deeper. But God says, you have to allow me to work in you before I work through you. You have to allow me to work in you before I work through you. before you begin to build others, I need to build you. You have to allow me to work in you. God says the throne of darkness, of iniquity, cannot reside with my presence. That city of the devil that still resides in us needs to be demolished so that we may be able to build a city for God. Say with me, Lord Jesus, I am here today. I received you many years ago. I was baptized with many waters many years ago. Lord, I pray, work in me so that, Lord, you can usher me into the next level of the Holy Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, work in me so that you can allow me to work for you. Even in the mighty name of Jesus, build me, equip me in the inside, Lord, so that you may release me to serve you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I bless your people. I cover everyone with the blood of Jesus, that, Lord, you will fill us with your Holy Spirit.